Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you that how you can integrate SCA, Strong Customer Authentication, in Stripe. So here is the overview. Actually this is this type of user interface we have required to do the payment. So actually I already implemented this. So firstly you should look at that, and then after we should move towards the coding section as well as the basic understanding of the Strong Customer Authentication in cards payment. So here is here I have created a demo in which there is this is actually there are two types of strong customer authentication. First is server integration and another is client integration. But for now in this video we are going to discuss server integration only. So for example, I have added already actually a product, cost, name, details, and all the thing. So now I am going to click on checkout. So here Stripe automatically provide us the user interface in which I have added my own product price, my own product name, and my own product description. All right, and image as well. So now I have to do the payment and the authentication, and all the stuff would be authenticated by Stripe itself. We have no need to do any validation and stuff like that. So for example, I am here going to put some dummy email and dummy cards. So for example, I don't want any authentication for now. So here I have put card information, and now CVC number testing for the sake of testing. So here I am just putting a name and then country name and then going to pay. So here we got a success message that payment successful. So might be you are thinking that why we haven't seen the customer authentication. So it is so because there are some testing keys in which the authentication is not done, but in some cases we do the same thing. For example, again I am going to click on checkout, and here I am again putting a different email, and now I am going to put the test card number in which the authentication is going to be performed. So here is a testing card number, so I'm going to put here that one and other information, and again I am going to put the name and country, and then again going to pay. So you can see that actually we are using it in testing mode of Stripe, so because of which we are getting this type of screen. Otherwise we get the authentication, for example OTP number or some other methods like text message or something like that. But for here, for example, we have two options: fail authentication and complete authentication. Actually this message would be shown to the user from where the user to whom the account number is related. For example, your account number, then this message would be shown to you only, because from your account number the money is going to be deduced. So for example, I am just cancelling this fail authentication. So in this way we will get the message that we are unable to authenticate your payment method. Please choose a different payment method and try again. It means that the person whose payment account is over there, whose card number, card information is this, he is not allowing us to do the payment. So it means that he will allow, then after the payment would be done. So again we are going to click on this button, and now if we are doing the complete authentication, then the payment would be successful. So in this case the payment get successful. It is so because the customer has allowed us to do the payment. All right, so again I am going to home page. So I think you got the overview of how I integrated this. So let me tell you over here that the Stripe is actually already providing all the facilities, all the coding structure and stuff like that, so that this should be more and more secure. So here you should go the documentation, check out, and you should go through this URL, stripe.com, docs, payments, checkout. Alright, so here you will get the strong customer authentication, so in which they have actually divided into two parts. So you have to read all the information over here, and then actually they already given us the preview checkout. So if we are doing something over here, then we can also do the, actually this product is not added by us, this product is for the sake of testing by Stripe itself. So here if I am going to do the same thing, but in this case they have redirected over here, welcome back, you successfully completed a purchase. All right so we have two ways to do the things. First is client integration and server, second is server integration. For example, in the Stripe dashboard, if you are adding the product details over there, then you should use this one, client integration. If you are providing the product information from the from your server files, then you have to use this way. Got the point? Because if you have a website, and on that website you have some products, and on checkout button you want to do the payment, so at that time you are getting the information of your product from your database and stuff like that, but you have to fetch that information, and because of which you could able to do the payment. But on the other hand, you can also have the facility that you can add that specific same product to the Stripe dashboard, and from there you can fetch the details, and once you will click on the checkout button, then that detail would be fetched from Stripe itself. So in this video we are only doing here server integration for now, and in the next video I will show you that how you can do the client integration as well. So in the server integration, once you will click on server integration quick start, then you will get the guidance that how you should integrate this. So actually this is some PHP code, and these are some JavaScript code. So all the things I have added to my, and this is the session in which we have to add the specific payment detail. For example, you have the product name, description, image, amount, currency and quantity. So you have to add this into your session, so that session, from that session the Stripe could get the details. So let's see in my code. So I have this index file. So in this I have the PHP code, in which firstly I have included the Stripe PHP library. So here is the folder of Stripe PHP. Alright so you have to add that into your file, then after you could able to use the Stripe methods and objects and all the things. So here you have to include secret key, then after you have to set the session. In the session you have to add your product name, right? So here is the product details, amount, image, description, name, currency, quantity. Then there is a success URL and cancel URL. In the success URL, if your payment is successful, then after the you will be redirected to this URL, otherwise you will be redirected to the cancel URL. Alright so here is the user interface, in which actually you have already seen that customer authentication, strong customer authentication, server integration, and the same button which you have seen just now on my own page. So here is some JavaScript, in which we have included publishable key, checkout session ID we fetched from the PHP code, and then checkout button. So here is the checkout button ID, the same ID is over here. So this is actually the SAM button, checkout button. So once that would be clicked, then you will be redirected to checkout, and the Stripe checkout checkout page would be shown to you, means the card details and all the things, the product information and all. So that would be shown to you, and then after, the payment process would be proceeded. So here in this SCA integration, I have only four files. First is readme file, in which I have added some test card numbers. So there are some numbers in which the customer authentication is done, and there are some others in which the customer authentication is not done. So this is for the sake of testing purpose. So this was the index file we already seen, and this is cancel page and this is success page. So if you are getting the successful payment, then you will be redirected to this this page. So here I have shown payment successful and something like that. And you can also do the database management, means once the successful, then you can add the details to your database that yes, we got the success after purchasing that specific product, right? So this was all about. So what you have to keep in mind is that you have to use the code which is mentioned in the documentation, because that is more and more secure. And other than that, for example, I am going to click on checkout, then this specific page is really important, because here we are putting some information. So if this information is sent securely, then definitely you can believe that my payment is done secure, in a secure way. Otherwise, if you are using a custom page, then you have to do the validation by your own self. So this is actually the boring stuff, right? So what you have to do is you have to use this checkout page, right? And then do the same process. So hope you understand the whole concept. In the next video, I will show you that how you can integrate the client in client integration, and in which we will do some things like we will add the product into the Stripe, and then from there we will fetch that, and this page would be shown here, and the customer detail and that product detail would be fetched from the Stripe dashboard, right? I am going to put the code onto my Git repository, so I will include the link into the description of this video. So you should click on that link and just get the code from my Git repository, so that you could get the help of integrating this specific functionality into your website. Thank you so much for watching this video. All the links of my video courses are below in the description, which are absolutely free. So in the next video, we would learn new and wonderful things. Please subscribe this channel firstly to get the information of updated videos. In the comment section, you can write your feedback about the video, and also write your queries if you have any. Have a nice day ahead.